866-5863-8446 volume toll free number. Let's talk to Mike, who's in Detroit. Hi, Mike.
Hey, Eddie, good to talk to you again. I don't know if you remember, but we spoke about a week ago when you were devoting a little bit of time from your show to ghosts and the whole image thing and how the metal guys are really into them and everything. Since then, of course, Rocklahoma's happened, and I'm assuming you got a chance to see them perform. And I'm really curious as to what your opinions are, but more importantly, my group, which is Ghost American Ministries on Facebook, really liked our conversation. A lot of our members listen to you, and they take your opinion serious. And they were kind of asking me, hey, can you get on and talk to Eddie again and ask him, does his opinion change? Does he have more thoughts on him now that perhaps he got to see them perform live?
Well, Mike, I talked about it in, when I came on the air on Tuesday. I did a whole recap, pretty much the entire show.
I'm sorry.
Yeah, no, that's okay. Of course, yeah, people can't hear every word every minute. I get that. But I did talk about all of Rocklahoma and basically spent the entire show on Tuesday recapping all the bands that I did see. And you can go back on the app and grab shows on demand if you'd like and listen to them if you missed them, if you want more on this. But as far as Ghost specific, specifically, Mike, what I said after seeing them for the second time live is that I appreciate the theatrics. I appreciate the stage show. They had a great production. And here's the other thing I appreciate. I love the fact that they actually sing, because again, I don't like the screamo stuff. I like the fact that they've got some catchy songs. And I like the fact that by all accounts from what I saw, they actually are playing everything live. A band like that could easily have tracks and have fake stuff running. To my vantage point, I went out front and watched them. They sounded like they were actually doing everything live, and they should be able to, because they have like 6-7 people on stage. And
that is an improvement. Before, in the previous incarnation of the band, they did use backing tracks.
Yeah, and it looked like that they absolutely weren't. I mean, they looked like they had one or two female members too, and they had a singer, you know, people singing and just, you know, really doing everything live, which I always applaud, because there's so many people running tracks and fake stuff. It's rampant out there, and it really bothers me and a lot of other people. So I like the fact that from what I saw with that many musicians, they were probably absolutely playing live. So I like all that about them. What I maintain about them is that I have not heard personally, in just my opinion, music that has blown me away. I've heard catchy songs, I've heard stuff that sounds good, but I've yet to hear anything that has blown me away that I'm like, wow, this band's amazing. It just hasn't happened yet. I mean, I think they've got catchy songs, and I like some of the things they've done. I play them. I have a radio show that plays music. I play them and have been playing them for years now. Pinnacle to the Pit, all of that stuff. But so it's not like I'm disconnected or late to the party or don't know their history or don't know that they had a little edgier stuff in their earlier years. I just haven't heard anything great musically to back up the hype. But you can't deny they're getting really big, and I'm rooting for all rock bands to get big. So for me, the jury's still out. I'm still waiting to hear a song or an album that totally blows me away. I have not yet, but everything that I've seen from them, I like what they're trying to do.
Well, the album drops tomorrow, so maybe you can get a chance and check it out, and maybe sometime later on your show, kind of, you know, check some of the tracks. There's a lot heavier tracks on there, not, you know, super heavy, still melodic, but there's some songs like Faith on there, and they do a cover from the Pet Shop Boys called It's a Sin. It's going over pretty good. And of course, Rats, you know, that was their kickoff.
Yeah, here's the thing that people have to understand. And thank you, Mike, for your call. And again, the band's doing just fine without me being in love with them. So nobody needs my approval here. But here's the one thing that I have to stress when I talk about this, when you talk about heavy. My issue with them is not, I think it's a weird disconnect that they have this image, but their music is not heavy. But my issue with them when I talk about their music is not the fact that it's not heavy. I love melodic music. I love clean vocals. I love melody. So there's not an issue at all with me direction-wise what they're doing. I just, like I said, I just think it's okay. I think that the hype machine, you know, I've said this before, and I had this conversation with someone the other day. It's this, the music industry has always been like this. If a couple people get on board with something that have a lot of clout and have a big following, whether it be, and I'm just using examples, maybe Dave Grohl or James Hetfield or somebody like that says something about a band in an interview or starts wearing the shirt. Everybody just immediately, it brings, and I'm not saying this is a bad thing, but it brings an immediate level of, oh, well, that's the band. I mean, everybody has to just automatically say they're great. And not take a second to have any sort of independent thought about it, because everybody just kind of falls in line. Radio, media, everybody, well, that's the band. They're the next big thing. And they get anointed as that, and nobody even really takes a listen and says, wait a minute, is what they're doing musically really any better than this band? Or is this band actually better musically, but we're so consumed with this band because the celebrities are talking about them and showing up in the videos and they've got this image and this stage show. So that's my only point. I just haven't heard music or songs that have floored me. And I've got friends who are producers, who are in the industry, who are musicians, telling me how great they think the band is, the music is, the what they're doing is. That's great. I'm just saying, to my ears, I don't hear it. I hear good. I hear catchy. I don't hear anything that's like, wow, these guys are amazing. And there's other bands that I feel that up and coming that I do feel that way about. So I think they get a lot of traction off of the look, off of the backstories that they create, and off of the fact that they are one of the two or three buzz bands in rock right now. And they're always going to get that sort of momentum because of that domino effect. Nothing wrong with it. Again, I can't. I want rock bands. I don't care if I like them or not. I want rock bands to break and get as big as possible because we need that. We need that to advance rock music. And I cannot stress enough. I'm not saying I dislike the band. I'm just saying I don't quite get what the excitement is about if you take away the stage show, the look, the image, and all that. Let's take a break. We'll come back. We got plenty of time left to go the rest of the hour. We got busy phones. We're talking rock with you live on this Thursday on Trunk Nation here on Volume.